The dwarf is unnaturally still. You might mistake her for a corpse, were it not for a slight twitch of her eyelids. She calmly opens her left eye, then her right.
What do you want? Nah, nice quiet spot for a dwarf to get some shut-eye. Cobwebs, I reckon. Maybe some spiders and silverfish, rats. Nothing you want, unless you collect cobwebs, I guess. Ain't hardly nothing. This is the warmest corner in the house, is all. And didn't I tell you to scram? Wine all you want. I'm staying and...
Before you can ask more, the dwarf holds up her hands and closes her eyes. She's done talking.
It won't budge.
might as well have rotted in the death fog. What's even the point? I'm approaching this the wrong way.
It won't budge.
Maybe if we had a crowbar.
You think a crowbar would open this thing? What? You got rocks knocking around that noggin of yours. We'd have more luck asking Duna to open it for us than for it to budge by our own hands.
What's this? I found something. The door's opening.
By Duna's dagger, Crimson Dragon, you here to free us or kill us?
You're not getting an answer till you keep your hands free of wands and such.
Good to see you'd rather flap your lips than fight. We're here looking for a slippery snake called Mordus. This here's his quarters, but ain't no sign of him.
Only thing we managed were to close that door behind us and get us stuck. Supposed to be another door out there, but never could find it.
Ain't no telling where that priest went off to. Started acting all funny not so long ago, then flew the coop. Well, at first, he was just buddying around with Lohar and the rest, you know. But then he'd start looking all sickly and run off for a day or two. Then some stranger tried taking old Lohar down, but got himself caught and tied up. Ain't no coincidence Mordus went hanging around then.
She taps a finger against her forehead.
A woman knows things. Nothing's getting past me. Best we head off then. We've got business to attend to.
What's this? I found something. Thank you.
The shrine depicts Duna, yet has clearly seen better days. Scratches and fissures deface its exterior, and its eyes have been gouged hollow. You scrape your knee on the wooden floor. Nothing else happens. The stone is cold against your palm. If this figure once held power, it has since been depleted.
Careful! I've spotted a trap. Well, this won't do. If I can get stuck, then I can get unstuck.
Thank you.
My hero. I'm grateful. What news of Gwydion Rhys? Have you found him?
She arches what would be an eyebrow if lizards had eyebrows.
Such a talented young sorcerer. In better times, he might have been a famous healer, a leader. But the Magisters have driven our kind into the shadows. Gwydion feared the great power within him. He did his best to hide it, but something so beautiful cannot stay hidden forever. A kind couple beseeched me to look after him, to teach him how to control his powers. I was happy to help, but it was never destined to last.
aid!
What's that smell?
Something delicious.
Where?
Close. Watching. But not for you. For Master.
Greetings and salutations. Have no fear, we mean you no harm. No harm, no harm.
The being sniffs the air in your direction and licks his lips. He moves a couple of paces towards you, his eyes hungry and entranced. He abruptly slaps himself in the face and halts his advance.
My manners. Master would not be pleased. He awaits you west of here. He will not harm you. Others may.
He doesn't respond at first. Instead, he stares, consuming you with his eyes. He bites his frayed lower lip, drawing blood.
Master is master. He wants you to go to him, west of here.
He barely seems to notice your repeated question at first. His eyes are dark pools in which your reflection is drowning.
You are so delicious. Please, go west. My master awaits.
Delicious.
A servant. A loyal servant.
He wrings his hands as he answers you. Rings them bloody.
Loyal and hungry. Go now. Save your questions from master. Spare me your presence.
He shoves his gnarled fist.
A loyal servant. Loyal.
The being lurches forward.
Sweet sir, handsome sir, seek out our master. He wants you. Wants you.
She gives you a coy little smile. Her mouth is crowded with dozens of tiny, sharp teeth. Shreds of rotten flesh are lodged between them.
Sweet thing, succulent thing. We are so pleased to see you, but not as pleased as him.
You look into her eyes and see screams. You hear her gaze upon your body and taste her carnal, violent lust, metallic and sharp as a blade in your mouth.
Go, speak to the advocate. Make him happy. Bring him pleasure.
The tree is surrounded, and the advocate has us skipping stones.
Okay, let's see what this master wants.
The trees.
How can I tell if he's to be trusted?
The advocate has us skipping stones.
You don't need me to tell you that.
Dark words should not sully those honey. True. I'm in deep, deep.
You want to buy something or not?
The lizard's eyes are dark as polished coal, void of all light.
No.
A faint frost seems to cover the cracked and broken scales around his mouth.
You have a reputation for both malfeasance and chaos. Imagine my surprise when it took you so long to find your way here. I see the miasma surrounding our islet certainly did not hinder you. Well, here you stand, in the flesh, so to speak. And a finer collection of corpusculae I never have seen. I trust you are not opposed to a mutually beneficial accord between civil and gentle persons. Ah, a curious mind, a most glorious creation. I am here at the behest of my master to offer you a simple exchange, an offer of aid for the promise of aid, the epitome of civil reciprocity. You and he possess a common foe. The power behind the Voidwoken has made our lives hell, so to speak, since the Divine Order unleashed death fog against the Black Ring and those darling woodland creatures. And as the gods have shirked their duty, perhaps we could come to a mutually beneficial arrangement pertaining to both of our objectives. Indeed, I can offer you the source channel that you seek forthwith, as a gesture of good faith. Excellent. My master has found your kind to be an eternally pragmatic group. The issue at hand is a simple one. We have suffered a Black Ring incursion into our sacred groves. They surround a tree that sits at the heart of this fair isle. Once the Black Ring have been eliminated, I have been authorized to send you on your way with that which you pursue, the location of the Council of Seven. But first, we shall see that you are fit. First, we shall grant you power beyond that of your meager mortal mind.
The lizard's hand lashes out, the palm landing flat on your forehead. You feel a cold pain start to spread across your skull, but deep within you, something stirs.
There is neither enigmatic lore nor magical jewel required to open the channels of Source. It is enough to seize it with sufficient force of will, to know that all creatures are nothing but Source and vain hope.
You feel the pull of a far-off connection. You feel the dungeon, the red organic tendrils binding you. Your ears are filled with screams, and you're surprised to find they are your own. Cold pain shoots through your veins, sharp and quick, but cleansing. You can feel your body opening up, filling with the promise of power as your ability to channel Source swells. The far-off connection fades, as do the screams. You feel empty, hungry, powerful.
Somewhat more roused, are you, Godwoken? It is such delicious vivication. Now, tell me, is there anything further in which you yearn to be enlightened?
It's incredible. I've never felt so alive.
You feel newfound powers of the Source course wildly through your body. Deep inside your soul, your god calls for you. It would be wise to meet with your god again by performing the Meister's Ritual, here or in Siva's vault.
It's you. I don't see why not. I've got business all around the realm, same as you. And I'm sure you'll tell me all about it, but not now. Now, if you'll leave me to my business.
Has faith in them, darling. That is all we need.
A hidden bridge. Clever. Very clever.